Hello everyone. So here we are with Android 4.4 and I'm going to take you through a few of the changes that have occurred, specifically the new phone dialer, because it just looks fantastic now. So the phone dialer has completely changed. They've gutted it and now it uses more of the card metaphor. Now the whole idea is to give you an easy way to search through all of your contacts and also nearby places as well. So if you happen to want to find a local restaurant or a local business, you can do a voice search for that or type in your search command. And that's all hooked up into Google's Now system. Google Now is basically integrated across Android 4.4, including into the phone dialer and to the home screen itself, which I'll show you in a moment. But all you need to do is come into here, you can do a search for the person you want to call, pull up their record and call. And if you actually speak a voice command there, call such and such, it will search through your phone book, find that person and calls them for you. You also have access to the phone dialer at the bottom and you can see it's got this lovely new animated slide out, which is just fantastic. And you can also go through and see all of your missed calls as well. If you come onto here, onto the little settings widget, you can then come into here and see all of your contacts, import and export, clear the frequency, which are anyone you've dialed recently, add new contacts, or go into the settings doing your caller ID and everything like that. The whole thing has been very nicely done, I must say. The whole way that a call is actually triggered works quite nicely, but still uses the old dialer, which is a bit of a shame, really. So we've kind of got partly a new front end on it, but the whole actual making the call bit is still very much the same. Now, when we actually come to our home screen, this is where things have really changed under the hood. Big thank you to Ars Technica who uncovered this one by having a bit of a poke around in the APKs. But effectively, where we used to have a launcher for Android Home, what we now have is Google Search, or Google Now as it's more commonly known, which is the home screen. It's really, really interesting. Effectively, the Google Now bar up at the top, the search bar, it is Android Home. It's integrated right the way across the desktop, which is why you can't remove it, you see. Now, within the actual underlying code that's powering the new home screen, what Ars Technica found was that the home launcher still exists, but there's nothing in it. The actual APK is empty, other than pointers telling any application that was using home Android Home APK for a particular reason, you know, particular calls, rendering icons, etc. Is effectively now saying simply go and look in the Google Now Google search area to find out how to interact with the Android desktop now, with Android home screen and launcher. In essence, Google have done what Facebook couldn't. They've managed to bring their search tools and, you know, the core really of what Google are all about directly integrated into a home experience. It's like Facebook Home but properly executed. And it works very, very well. You can still happily install any launches you want, but obviously you will lose that functionality. But what it does allow you to do is this. Okay, Google. Okay, Google. So straight away from the home screen, I can trigger a voice command. Whoops. Obviously, it's going to find me a strange way home. Now, to actually enable Google Now, if you're outside the US, you'll have to set your speech settings to English US. Doesn't work on English UK, but once you do, then you get what we could probably describe as live searching with Google Now. So all I have to do is say, okay Google, what's the weather like today?
Today's forecast for Harrogate is 52 degrees with rain.
So there you go.